Hello, and welcome to The Chemistry Solution. This tutorial is on heat capacity and specific heat. Heat capacity is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of an object by 1 degree Celsius. The difference between heat capacity and specific heat is that heat capacity is an extensive property, and it's dependent on the amount of a substance that you have. Specific heat, in contrast, is an intensive property, and is independent of the sample size. Specific heat is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 gram of a material by 1 degree Celsius. Another way of saying extensive or intensive properties is to say extrinsic or intrinsic. We know that Q is energy in the form of heat, and Q is equal to the specific heat of a substance times the grams of that substance times the temperature change. Let's go ahead and look at an example. How many kilojoules of heat are required to raise the temperature of 365 grams of water from 68 degrees Celsius to 90 degrees Celsius, given that the specific heat of water is 4.18 joules per gram degree Celsius? We know that Q is equal to the specific heat times the grams of the substance times the change in temperature. So Q is going to be equal to our specific heat. So the specific heat is 4.18 joules for every gram degree Celsius. This means that 4.18 joules of energy are required to raise 1 gram of water 1 degree Celsius. We know that we have 365 grams of water. Because the specific heat is given to us in joules per gram degree Celsius and our sample size is given to us in grams, this allows us to cancel out units of grams. We know that delta T, or the change in temperature, is equal to 22 degrees Celsius. And we calculate delta T by taking our final temperature minus our initial temperature. So our final temperature is 90 degrees Celsius minus the temperature we started at, or 68 degrees Celsius. This gives us a delta T value of 22 degrees Celsius. And this is something important to note. Sometimes specific heat values will be given to you in joules per gram Kelvin. And although the numerical values for a temperature given in degrees Celsius or Kelvin are different, delta T in degrees Celsius and delta Kelvin for two given temperatures will be the same. And so let's take a look at that. Remember that Kelvin is equal to a temperature in degrees Celsius plus 273. So the absolute values of Kelvin and degrees Celsius are different numbers. But a change in 1 degree Celsius is equal to a change in 1 Kelvin. And so if my final temperature was 90 degrees Celsius, that would equal a temperature of 363 Kelvin. And my initial temperature was 68 degrees Celsius. That would be equal to 341 Kelvin. If I now look at delta T, I can see that delta T is 22 degrees Celsius and is also 22 Kelvin. So for problems involving delta T, as long as your values are given to you in degrees Celsius or Kelvin, you do not need to convert these temperatures in order to cancel with your given specific heat value, if your specific heat value is given to you in different units. And remember, that's only if you're working with Celsius and Kelvin. This doesn't apply to any temperatures given in Fahrenheit. But typically, when you're working with problems in the sciences, you're working on either the Celsius or the Kelvin scale. Going back to our problem, we can cancel degrees Celsius, and we come up with an answer of 33,600 joules. But our problem is asking us how many kilojoules of heat are required. So we need to convert joules to kilojoules. Remember that 1,000 joules is equal to 1 kilojoule. This allows us to cancel out units of joules and come up with a final answer of 33.6 kilojoules. Let's look at another example. What is the specific heat of aluminum if 2,230 joules are required to raise the temperature of a 45-gram sample from 30 degrees Celsius to 85 degrees Celsius? We'll go back to using our same equation, although this time we're going to solve for the specific heat. So we can rearrange that equation to tell us that the specific heat is equal to Q divided by the mass of the sample divided by delta T. We know that Q is equal to 2,230 joules, as given to us in the problem. We divide that by the mass of the sample, 45 grams. And we also divide Q by the change in temperature, delta T, which is 55 degrees Celsius. And you'll notice that none of our units cancel. And that's all right because specific heat values are normally given to us in joules per gram degree Celsius. And when you punch these numbers into your calculator, you should come up with 0.900 joules per gram degree Celsius. Thanks for watching The Chemistry Solution. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial.